Back at it again with another top 10 countdown. For more content, make sure you like and subscribe. Let's go.
Stranger.
Still don't know my name. Wish you come over. Miss you, kiss you, and make believe.
Okay, y'all, Thanksgiving is over. Now we have to find something to eat that's not gonna keep us in the kitchen all day and all night, okay? So we finna make some chicken enchilada rice. So real easy. You're gonna brown up some chicken. Okay, I had chicken thighs. That's what I had. That's what I used. I diced up an onion. I threw that in there, sauteed it. You're gonna add some corn, some black beans, and some cooked rice. Okay, get you a big can of enchilada sauce. Big can of enchilada sauce. Cut you up some diced tomatoes. Not diced tomatoes, but cut up a tomato. Put some cheese in there. Put some sour cream in there and a little bit of water. And then you just let it steam all together. And then boom, you got chicken enchilada rice on a weeknight. Hope y'all enjoy.
Different apple pie lollipops, come on. Now first thing, you want to get the butter in the pot melted and then add the apples. Now hit it with the cinnamon, nutmeg, brown sugar, vanilla, and a little bit of that white stuff. Now grab some pie crust and you're gonna cut out some circles. I used a cup because I didn't have a cutter, don't judge me. Now the sticks I got off Amazon, you're gonna add that apple pie filling to the center. And you're gonna cover it with another piece of pie crust. You see, I got fancy. I did a little decorations on mine. Don't copy off me though, but yeah. Oh, also, please try not to put so much apple pie filling in the center because your lollipops will definitely fall apart. I bake these in the oven on 375 for about 20 minutes or to your liking. And then I whipped up some glaze, put them on top. And it was pretty, man, pretty. What y'all think?
Dog. Oh, the dog. Why? I can run. Oh, oh, I said, ooh, your word I would recite, so I can sleep until I feel your touch. I said, ooh, I'm drowning in the night. Oh, when I'm like this, you're the one I trust. I'm running out of time, 'cause I can see the sunlight up the sky. Praying that your help will soon arrive, Robbie. Oh, I'm feeling cold and empty. So many more will judge me. I can see clearly, I can run. Oh, oh, I said, ooh, your word I will recite, so I can sleep until I feel your touch.
Got tired of reeing up and trapping. Now a nigga sick of rapping. All of this shit just too basic. My past, I wish I could erase it. My bitch asked what I wanna do.
Time someone asks me what's my favorite meal to eat, it has to be chicken parmesan, hands down. Let me show y'all how to get done. So to make this chicken parmesan, all you gotta do is get a chicken breast that's been flattened out and butterflied and some flour, coated in some seasoned egg wash, and then some seasoned breadcrumbs. So I set that aside for a few minutes, and then I started working on the sauce with what you see on the screen right now. Finish it off with some Italian seasoning and spices, and just let that simmer on low. I fried up my chicken cutlet until it was nice and golden brown on each side for a few minutes, and then I set that aside. I'm serving this chicken parmesan with some spaghetti noodles, so I got that into some boiling salted water. I topped the chicken cutlets with some marinara sauce, some mozzarella cheese, and plenty parmesan cheese. Italian seasoning, some crushed red peppers, and got that into the oven until it was nice and golden and bubbly. I tossed those spaghetti noodles in some of that marinara sauce, and then I plated it up next to that chicken parmesan. I like to top mine off with some more of that marinara, some parmesan cheese, maybe a little more crushed red pepper, and look, it's a wrap. Let's go.
Happy Juneteenth, y'all. Let's make some steaks. So first things first, you gotta get you some tomahawk steaks. Don't be cheap. Get the tomahawks, season them up real good. It don't take much, okay? Get you some butter, and you add whatever kind of bacon you like, whatever kind of parsley you like, and add some garlic, and then you just mix it up, right? Get some saran wrap. Lay that butter down in there, right? And then just mix it up and put it in the refrigerator so it can like stiffen a little bit. So after you do that, you go to the grill with your steaks and they come out looking pretty like that. And then once they come out pretty like that, you put them on your plate. You take that butter that you made and you just lay it on the top. And oh my God, look at the razzle dazzle right here. Oh my goodness, the butter is melting. Oh my God, it's so good. Anyway, so you slice into it, and we like our steaks a little rare around here. So if you like yours burnt, keep it on the grill longer. But don't judge me for liking it rare, okay? Oh my God, this steak was so good. The weather in Philadelphia today is a high of 83 and low of 57. Ew.